My name is Vincent Reid, and I'm at Mercy Medical Center in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, where I'm the Chief of Surgery and the Medical Director of our Cancer Center. I actually looked at multiple options. The things I was looking for, one, something that would remain MRI friendly, given the need for MRI in a certain subpopulation of our patients. As I look at the wire-free localization space, I really see three components. I see the magnets, and there are a number of magnet companies. I think there are four or five out there now of the magnets. I see a technology based on RFID. And then, of course, there's the scout technology based on radar. And I think that, again, if I'm looking at something that met all the aforementioned criteria in terms of ease of placement, not migrating, giving me the ability to utilize MRI where necessary in my practice. If I look at all of those and I compare all of those, the magnets, which is a group of reflectors, RFID and Scout, I think that Scout remains, in my mind, the only one who gives me that flexibility and meets all of those aforementioned criteria. So I'm definitely placing Scout in my neoadjuvant patients before the initiation of treatment. I think that's a benefit because, you know, as patients go through this process, the multiple appointments and the many things that they need to do, the more you can simplify their life, or the more you can decrease the need for the back and forth, that's significant. So once my patients finish neoadjuvant chemotherapy, for example, after the last dose of cytotoxic chemotherapy, we like to get them in between 4 to 6 weeks after the completion of neoadjuvant chemotherapy. So with those kind of tight timelines, it's sometimes difficult to get patients back to the Department of Radiology to have the reflector placed. It's not that easy, and somebody has to follow that. So it takes a lot of doing. So if I can get all of that done up front, which I do, it is very, very significant, and it changes the flow for the patient. And completely changes the workflow and makes it so much easier for me to get those patients to definitive surgical therapy. When you start looking at requirements to get patients from the time of biopsy to surgery, being able to get things done in a timely fashion, being able to get things done faster is very, very important. And that is why I think that the Scout having an indication for placement at the time of biopsy is so important. Because although that may be a moving target, I don't see that time getting longer. I see that time probably getting shorter as newer recommendations come out. So I think that's one of the reasons why having the ability to put it at the time of biopsy is so important. Based on my experience, I've done over 600 cases with the device. And I think I can count on one hand probably the amount of devices that I've deactivated. I think, just kiddingly, I like to say that if you're persistently deactivating Scout, you're persistently hitting device, you may have other margin issues that needs to be addressed independently. I've also had the opportunity to play with the new device, the Scout MD device, which is much, much more difficult to deactivate because of the capacitance and et cetera. So I think that while that is a minor problem currently, even that minor problem is gonna be resolved with the new platform. But outside of the breast, I've taken it to other areas. I've taken it to looking at lymph nodes from melanoma. I've done, as you know, quite a few cases, using it to localize parathyroid adenomas. So I've taken it into the neck for parathyroid surgery. I've taken it into the axilla, the groin, and other areas for melanoma surgery. And you know, sometimes you have to remove a suspicious lymph node in the abdomen for some disease processes. And I've placed Scout in those locations. So I've found it to be reliable in almost any location so far that I've taken the device.